Attitude, boys. Today we're here to talk about why trying to impress a woman turns her off. Now guys, don't nothing tell a woman she is out of your league more than you trying to impress her. And what do I mean by when I say trying to impress her? Trying to tell her in this lie how much money you make. Talking about how great your job is. Yeah, I got this many guys working up under me. Blah, blah, blah. I've traveled here. I've traveled there. I'm traveling here next week. Guys, essentially what you are seeing. I know I'm out of your league, but let me tell you all these great, nice, wonderful things that I have going on, and maybe you like me. Because me as is isn't good enough, you understand what I'm saying? Let me give you a story. I went to the bar with a girl once. She was good looking, not a 10 out of 10 good looking, but let me say like a 7. I met her on Instagram, but she didn't really quite look like her pictures, you know, so. And on the date, I could tell that she thought to herself that I was out of her league because she started seeing stuff like, oh, she liked to cook for she man, she liked to clean, she liked to give she man back rubs. And instantly, it turned me off because it validated what I was already thinking, that I am out of this bitch league. Her saying that made me feel like she thought that I was out of her league too. So, she essentially started selling herself. That's the same thing that you guys are gonna be doing to women when you try to impress them. Guys, you let whatever you are sell itself for you. You understand what I'm saying? You let the person that you are, you let everything speak for itself. So, if you are a successful guy, then you just dress nice, and you look nice, and you're confident, and you be yourself. You let that speak for you, okay? You don't have to do no rascal talking to try to impress anyone. You let that do all the talking for you. One time, I went out with this girl, a real nice girl, real sweet girl, like a 9 out of 10, or 10 out of 10. And the girl lived like 2 blocks away from the bar we were chilling at. And she was like, oh, don't worry, I'll catch a van home. I'll catch a bus home. And I insisted on taking her home. I was insisting because I wanted her to see my fucking Jeep. And then I get in the Jeep and I push up my chest and I sit in all up like, yeah, you know? And she wasn't really impressed because she knew why I wanted to take her home. She knew I wanted her to see my Jeep. You see guys, you have to understand that women are not stupid. She knew that I wanted to take her home. She knew why I wanted to take her home. And that was a turn off for her. Because me doing that is saying to her that I am not good enough as is. So I need my Jeep to get you to like me. I need my Jeep to attract you. Listen guys, if you have a nice vehicle, let the vehicle speak for itself. But don't be twisting nobody's arm to take them home so that they can see your car. She knows why you are trying to take her home so that you can show off your car. So, let your car speak for itself. If she asks you for a ride home, then you let your car speak for yourself. You don't insist on taking the girl home. And you definitely don't get in the car and start talking about how great it is. That is you trying to use your vehicle to attract the chick. That is a very big turn off. So, my brothers, one thing you need to know is, whenever you do some shit like that, you're basically sending a signal to the woman's brain that you're out my league. I'm not good enough for you as is, so let me tell you all these wonderful things that I have accomplished in my life. And maybe you'll like me. Guys, that is a fucking turn off. Rude boys, don't do no shit like that. Don't be fucking, if you have a nice watch, don't be on the fucking date checking your time every fucking 5 minutes. So you could flash your ass glad watch. You don't do shit like that. She knows why you keep checking the fucking time. You because you want her to see a fucking watch. So, what's the QE that I have came up with? If you want to impress a girl on the sly. One way I came up with, a sneaky way to do it, is I always leave like a very generous tip, like a 30% tip on the first date. So, I leave the tip, and then I go and use the bathroom. Now, when you're gone, she is gonna check to see what that tip is. But you never leave it out. You close it up like you didn't. You never wanted her to see it. So you never leave it out. You close it up and then you excuse yourself to the bathroom. That is a sneaky way to, you know, get your point across that she is gonna find highly attractive because she sees that you are caring, you're taking care of your waitress, but you didn't flaunt it. That's one sneaky thing that I have always done, and I have always gotten a good response off that. I always see women get a little more energetic whenever I do my tip drill. I call that my tip drill. I always leave a generous tip, nothing too crazy, like 25-30% of the cost of the date, probably about 30%. Then I go to use the restroom soon after I leave the tip, and I close it up, and I know the girl is gonna check to see what I tipped. So guys, you can do that little tip drill if you want to, or something similar, but never try to impress a woman. You're good enough as is, it's the biggest fucking turn off in the world. Even if a girl might think that you're on her level, as soon as you do some shit like that, she'll start thinking like, oh, you're beneath her, because you're trying to impress her, right? Like, comment, subscribe. Like I said, guys, we ain't impressing these bitches from now on. We're good enough as is, we're getting on our grind, and we're gonna fuck them girl till them pass out. We're gonna catch up with you later. Respect.